Welcome to Jericho City, changing the lives of many. Come on in.
Anybody can see a prophecy fulfilled, but it takes discernment to see a prophecy in progress. Because the process don't allow it to look like what it's going to be. But the Bible says it does not yet appear what we shall be. Yes, Lord. And tell him I'm over it. Now I can praise him for real. Cause pure praise is when I'm praising God whether he blesses me or not. Are not priority. Challenge what is priority. The point I'm trying to make is you never let a number four violate a number one. If I have declared that Jesus Christ is my priority, and if my financial success is number four, and when number four doesn't pan out, because in the beginning, after all, it's a number four. And so from the very beginning of this setup of my life, I declared that number four was never going to be as important as number one. So even when the finances are not there, now the finances, number four, may be able to affect a number five or a six, but it can't affect a number one if in fact I have already declared that Christ is my priority. Come on, ask him again. What are you willing to give up for what you believe that is on the way? See, because if you really have confidence in what's on the way, this right here, what I got, what else you need? Because what's to come is better than what. And we will put stuff on the layaway for ourselves. Because we have become our priority. But can I tell you this? If you are your priority, that means you're sowing your priority into flesh. And the Bible says, if you sow into the flesh, of the flesh you reap corruption. But if you sow into the spirit, you reap life and peace. peace. Am I talking to anybody? If you made up in your mind, God, this is what I'm going to do for you today, regardless what happens in between, that covenant agreement and the time to bring it to pass. Don't let a number three. Can I mess with you some more? If God is first, everybody else in your life is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Don't you let a number three or four person interfere with your commitment and obligation to your number one God. People will get mad at threes and fours in church and won't come to church to give God, who's the number one, praise. Look at your neighbor and tell them, neighbor, because of where I have prioritized you in my life, tell them there's nothing you can do to keep me from this place. Watch this. So if my first fruit for the year is holy, and the Bible says, as she just read in the book of Romans chapter 11, it says now that the rest of the lump is holy as well, then that means that the rest of my wealth for the year is holy and consecrated to God. Now, I didn't say your job. I say your wealth. What you got to understand something, when you know that you have consecrated your whole year of wealth, it doesn't matter if you go to work on March the 4th and they tell you this is your last day, because you got to know, because you sold your first fruit harvest and your wealth for the year is holy, either God's getting ready to give you an unscheduled vacation or he's got an opportunity waiting for you that you were not expecting. And some of y'all, when you lose jobs and get fired, you don't know how to enjoy the free vacation. You spend all the time worrying about how you're going to get bills paid. But what you're going to understand is, while you were worrying, the bills still got paid some kind of way. So why you going to sit up all day long and worry and be angry and frustrated and attitudinal and cussing everybody out and being mean to the kids, while God's been making the way the whole time? Maybe what God's trying to do is give you an unscheduled vacation. Maybe he wanted some time with you. So while you off of work, spend some time praying instead of complaining. Is because Romans chapter 11 got to be right. When she made the cake and gave the first of it to the prophet, then that automatically consecrated the rest. And what is consecrated? Why, oh God, here I come. And here is an indication of what is consecrated. Because anything that is consecrated, it multiplies automatically. Can I tell you that principle living is going to violate your personal needs? If, matter of fact, if it don't violate your personal need, it's probably not principled living. Because God has an uncanny way of pushing us to do things that violate our personal space. Some of y'all had to be broke long enough to get comfortable being broke, so that when your test came, you could pass the test. Can I tell some of y'all, you ain't just start struggling, you've been struggling, but now you're facing a struggle that's getting ready to release your harvest. But what I'm saying is, when you have given God the first, it consecrates the rest. And how you know something is consecrated is because it multiplies automatically. Look at somebody and tell them 2010 is going to be the year of automatic increase. My money getting ready to start growing on accident. You got to understand something. The Holy Ghost is what he gives me as a down payment before I get to see him face to face. Not only is the Holy Ghost a down payment, but the Holy Ghost is a guarantee. Because the Holy Ghost is what's going to get me back to him. I ain't surface enough. Y'all want me to talk about he going to heal your body? Mm-mm. We ain't talking about that. I want you to understand something. The Holy Ghost is the first fruit of God's presence. But if it's the first fruit of God's presence, you got to know there's more of him to come. The Bible says it does not yet appear what we shall be, but what does it say? But we shall be like him, for we shall what? See him how? We ain't seeing him as he is right now, because all we got is the Holy Ghost. And the only thing we can see of God is what God allows the Holy Ghost to manifest among us. Eyes haven't seen and ears haven't heard. Can I tell you that what the Holy Ghost is doing among the people right now is only a foretaste of what's on the way? That's why this is not the time to be distracted. This is not the season for broken focus. This is the time where we got to hold on to God, because the Bible is true. What's to come is greater than what's been. Can I tell you that the little miracles and manifestations that we've seen over the past 2 or 3 years, tell somebody that ain't nothing compared to what it's going to be like when we get before him. That means the rest of my year, I ain't going to have no money that I can't do what needs to be done. Now, I ain't going to have enough to do all a bunch of foolishness, but I'm going to have enough to do what needs to be done. regardless of economy, regardless of recession, regardless of politics, because the Bible teaches us that even in times of recession, the saints will be satisfied.
5200 Jensen's Drive. 5200 Jensen's Drive. 5200 Jensen's Drive.